Jesus, our affection, our devotion, poured out on the feet of Jesus, our affection, our devotion, poured out on the feet of Jesus, our affection, our devotion, poured out on the feet of Jesus.
Talk about how he can offer me living. time I didn't understand, so I asked him about it. He said that everyone who drinketh of this water shall thirst again. But whosoever drinketh of the water I shall give shall never thirst. I thought to myself, who is this man? Never thirst again? What type of water is this? Is it even possible to never thirst again? So I asked him for some, so that I won't have to walk all the way down to the well to draw. It's a long walk to Jacob's well. And then the conversation all of a sudden changed, and he started to ask me. No, he started to tell me about my husbands. He knew how many husbands I had had previously. Well, he even knew that the man I was currently with was not my husband.
Amen.
I thought to myself, how does he know these things? He must be some type of prophet or something. And then we start to talk about our different views on worship, and I mentioned the coming Messiah. I guess I wanted to impress him of my knowledge of the subject, but I knew nothing. He said, I am the Messiah. Mm. When he said that, I immediately dropped my pail and I ran home as fast as I could. I told as many people as I could tell, and I gathered them all up so that they could come to the well so that they can hear him. I don't know how I convinced so many people to come. I guess it was because I convinced myself. But this man knew everything that I had done. I can't explain it. He spoke with such authority and with words that reached inside of me and touched my very heart. I felt so ashamed of all the wrongdoings that I had done, and yet he spoke to me as if there was still hope in life waiting for me. He spoke of living water. That man had answers. You see, I have been searching and searching and searching for so long just for love and meaning in my life, and each and every single time I would just get pain, 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 and failure. But when he spoke to me, it was as if he could see inside my soul. Little did I know that this man, the Messiah, would die a horrible, horrible, horrible death on the cross just a few years later. Had I known the prophecies about him, I would have been more prepared for it. But I guess none of us really knew. And that was the man I loved.
Rumors and was afraid.
But my love for Jesus was stronger than my fear.
I didn't know what would happen, but I knew that Jesus was the Lord Messiah.
I wanted to put that knowledge into action. See, back in the days of old, kings, priests, and prophets were anointed with oil to symbolize God's choice to make them his own. Nowadays, we only anoint the dead, when it used to be a sign of life, a sign of God's favor. And I knew God favored Jesus. So, I went out and I bought an oil, a perfume made of pure nard.
A whole pound of it. It was very expensive, but it was worth it.
I wanted people to see Jesus the way that I did. I wanted them to know that he was the Messiah, the chosen one of God. So, I brought in the oil, and I knelt at Jesus' feet. I rubbed the oil on him, and I wiped the excess away with my hair. I think Martha may have been a bit embarrassed because it was so unusual and impractical. And Judas, he's one of Jesus' followers. He mumbled something about how expensive it was and how we should give it to the poor. And for a second, I thought Jesus would agree. After all, Jesus always wanted us to help one another. But you know, Jesus didn't. Jesus said something very strange. He said, she bought this oil so that she may have it on the day of my burial. The poor will be with you always, but you will not always have me. I had no idea he would leave me so soon. And that was the man that I loved.
I can't forget.
You see, long ago, a sickness attacked my body. And I just began developing these sores all over my body. And these sores slowly oozed with blood. And that affected me in many different ways. First, it was the physical toll that it took on my body. And the blood that I lost, it was never enough to kill me. So that wasn't a concern. But it did weaken me. You know, the human body was never meant to lose blood constantly. And so over time, I just grew weaker and weaker and weaker. Days turned into weeks. Weeks turned into months. Months turned into years. 12 long years I bled. 12 long years I suffered. Do you know what it feels like to suffer with the sickness for 12 long years? 12 long years I was lonely. 12 long years I was depressed. 12 long years I was isolated from friends and family. My own children wouldn't come near me. 12 long years. And so one day, I decided to wait by the road, watching, straining my eyes to see this man that could heal me. You know, something within me whispered that this was not just an ordinary man. That this wasn't just a holy man. That this was the Messiah. And he had the power to heal me and to end my suffering.
Amen.
A small voice whispered to me, and I believe that voice with every part of me. I believe that I wouldn't even need to ask him. I believe that he wouldn't even need to touch me. I believe that all I would need to do is just touch the hem of his garment. And the power of God would come upon me, the power that I had been praying for 12 long years, would come upon me and heal my body. Well, soon the crowd just grew bigger and bigger, and they began to press past me. Well, when they pressed past me, I caught a glimpse of him with my very eyes. I saw Jesus.
Amen.
I saw Jesus. No one had to tell me who he was, for the power of God shone through him. And I knew that this was my only chance, that this was my opportunity. And so I risked everything. I dropped everything. I ducked my head and I just began to push through the crowd. Not caring who I touched, not caring who I was making unclean. I just pushed. I pushed and I pushed and I pushed, drawing nearer and nearer and nearer until finally I was close enough. I reached out my fingers and I gently brushed the edge of his cloak as he walked past me. And in an instant, the very moment that I touched the hem of his garment, in an instant I was healed. The blood completely stopped. In an instant I was because God had answered my prayer.
Amen.
God had answered my prayer, the very prayer that I had been praying every single day. He healed me. Well, Jesus, he stopped right there in the middle of the crowd. And he said, someone touched me. He says, I felt virtue leave my body. Who touched me? And I was afraid that he might condemn me. But I slipped my hand up and I said, I touched you. And he looked at me with love in his eyes. And he said, daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace. And from that moment on, my life has never been the same. And that was the man.
To listen. And he saw me. It was as if he knew everything about me just by the way he looked at me. I fell to his feet. And he raised me up with his hands on my head. And he began to command evil spirits to come out of me. Lord, evil spirits commanded to come out of me. What was this? There were times where I didn't know who I was or where I was. I knew that I had been a sinner. I would have lapses in memory, and I would wake up wondering where I had been. I would wake up wondering what I had done. It was as if something or someone had taken over my body. I was completely out of control. See, you hear about people being possessed by demons, but I wasn't sure if I believed that kind of talk. Yet I knew that something was wrong with me. I knew that it was because of the life that I led that demonic spirits were able to enter into my body. There were seven of them. My Lord and Savior cast seven demons out of me that day. He cast out guilt. He cast fear out and poverty, witchcraft, hate, and bondage. He told me that I was a new creature. He told me that I was free, and I could feel his love, and I could feel the relief. The love of God just engulfed me. He told me that my sins, all of my sins were forgiven. He told me that. And I know because of that, that my life will never, ever, ever be the same. And I was so unworthy to receive such a gift from this teacher. And that was the man that I loved. I have to go see him. I have to find him. I have to just see his body. I have to see him. Where is he? Where is my Lord? Someone has taken him.
opening up the doors of his house, amen. And giving those, if this play ministered to you, amen. Maybe you could relate to some of the issues that these women went through in their encounters with Jesus, amen. I would hate for you to leave this place carrying the same load, carrying the same burdens, the same issues, amen. When we have a Savior who has made himself available to you as a free gift. And he says, all you have to do is receive me into your life, into your heart. And so if there's anyone here today who's saying, I want this gift of salvation. I want to encounter Jesus in a real way this Easter. Amen. If that's you, I want you to come to the front. If we could all stand, amen. If that's you, I want you to come to the front. We want to pray with you. Maybe you're here and you're saying,